Hello.
You want to be in it?
This is Jerry. Thank you for giving us a ride today. This has been so fun.
It's okay. That's good.
This is wicked.
You're one of the lovely ride.
You're one of the few people that's given us a ride that's done a lot of hitchhiking themselves.
Is that right?
Yes. And it was really interesting for you to share with us your adventures, especially about the hot dude.
He thought he was hot.
This guy was, this truck driver started taking off all his clothes, hoping she'd be aroused.
I was not. And I kept mine on till the bitter end.
She stayed cool even though it was very hot.
Yeah.
No, but this has been a lovely, lovely ride. If you want to tell
us
any
stories. This has been a hot ride too, but everyone has kept their clothes on.
Yes.
You know,
praise the Lord. We've got to praise the Lord for that.
Thank you. Peter, it's very nice to see you. Thanks for having me in your place here.
That's
nice
cool.
to be back.
Yeah.
It's nice to see that healthy crop of hair up there sprouting out.
And indeed, yeah.
Well, so now tell
me. Looser and freer.
Tell me about this new guitar that you've built here.
Here it is. It's one of the few guitars I've attempted to make out of nearly all New Zealand woods.
Yes. Is this, what body style do you call this?
This one is actually called the Jazz.
And it's, is it modeled after another a commercially available guitar?
In some respects. The design is just ones that I'm, shapes that I'm familiar with. Narrow waist, elegant, you know, rounded lower bout.
Hitchhiking, we're at Lake Tekapo, where we hitchhiked here from Littleton yesterday, and we got a ride with this cool dude named Pierce, who's like a surfer and snowboarder and a filmmaking guy, dropped us here at Lake Tekapo, where all these tour buses are coming to take people to see. We're going to see the little stone church that you see in the postcards, where all the people get married and stuff, but no one goes to church, and it's at a beautiful location. But anyway, well, he dropped us by the side of Lake Tekapo here. It's very beautiful. And we set up our tent on the rocks, which was okay, and sat there with the moon and made soup and got stoned and had a really brilliant, lovely evening. And it was very, very nice. We heard all kind of ducks and other bird sounds all through the night. And it was very, very awesome. And it was very tempting for us to consider staying there all day today, because we easily could have. But once you get to Fjordland, you'll see that that's where we need to go, because it's extremely beautiful and spectacular. And the power of nature is so great that the first time I went there, I actually felt like I was getting so much energy from the land that I didn't even need to eat any food. No food at all for Jeff.
Now we have to go all the way back to Queenstown, to Frankton, to Kingston, all the way to Mossburn, all the way to Taranau, and then. Thank you. Whoa, there's a sky.
Who dares disturb my sleep?
Going very slowly, isn't it?
They all follow each other.
I like sheep.
was this Robin.
Robin, yeah.
Robin stopped and gave us a ride there outside the Big Prawn in Ballina after we were hitching for 2 hours. Dude, thanks for stopping, man. So you're a musician.
Yeah.
And originally from England.
Yeah.
And you play bass.
Mm-hmm.
You got a Rickenbacker back there.
Yeah, I'm going down to Melbourne to, I got this friend, Moose. He writes songs. As you know, there's not many people in the world write songs. This guy writes songs, and he's getting positive things about his music all over the world. So going down to Melbourne to get him started up.
Okay. But so you quit uni. You wouldn't become an Australian citizen because of the Aboriginal issue.
Yeah, that's right. I don't like the fact that they're separate people from the rest of the human race.
It's very racist, isn't it?
Sure is.
So now to Peter Garrett.
Peter Garrett. Yeah. Well, I'm a musician too, so.
Yes. But you're not also not the Minister of the Environment.
No.
Or a lawyer.
Yeah, he did a couple of good songs, and everything he's done since then, I think. There's probably somebody better for the job.
That's one of the kinder things that we've heard. notice how the front of this building is tilted forward.
That's cool, isn't it? This is like a map where all his things are in Germany. And then I think, yeah.
Now you can talk.
Hello.
Hello.
This is Claudia and Christiane and LIESBET, and we're here at the Hundertwasser. What is the exact name of this place?
Children. Kindergarten.
Children in the kindergarten.
Okay. And it's a place that Hundertwasser designed, and there are two of the teachers here, and we've left all these rocks for the kids and the people that work here. And thank you so much for taking the time to talk with us.
Thank you
very
much.
Thank you.
A creative room for the children. Hundertwasser says, this is my lovely room. This is for sports, workout room.
Okay.
The greatest room in this house.
Really?
Breakfast.
Okay.
Every day, every morning.
Yes.
And this is
That's well, that how cool. Wow!
This is original from Vienna.
Well, we have seen this book.
Yes.
Not that one?
No.
Okay.
Different.
This, I believe, this has every painting of his in it, doesn't it?
Genau.
Wow.
Children like looking in it?
Yes, 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 every day, yes.
Water, raindrops, tears. Water on the sea, water in the rivers, water in the lakes, water falling from the sky and water falling from the ice. It is true that water fascinates me. Water is for me a way to escape, which is always open. My spiral is not a geometrical spiral. My spiral is a biological, plant-like spiral. It is not something you can measure. My spiral develops bulges and irregularities and obstacles. When I paint, I am dreaming. I mean, when the dream is over, I can't remember what I dreamed, but the picture is there. It's the fruit of the dream.
Chicken.
Thank you.
The sea has been giving birth today. Turtles. Barramundi. Snubfin dolphin. Stingray. They look very clean.
They are.
Oh, I'm still a little wet.
I'm fluffy.
Teddy, you like, you smell like eucalyptus. Snoochie, you too.
Smell them.
This is Nigel. I don't know your last name.
Harris.
What if it was Gavin?
No, it's not Gavin.
Okay.
And I don't play guitar. I play trumpet, piano, accordion.
Wow, we've been listening to a lot of Miles Davis recently.
Oh, cool.
But, hey, first of all, sorry about that.
It's okay.
But thanks for giving us a ride.
Pleasure.
And where you're going to Sydney.
Yeah, I've just picked up this car from Gold Coast. And so I thought I'd share my adventure with you guys. Hopefully not share any grief. Hopefully we make it.
Yes, even though we don't have a first gear.
Yes. Well, we've got it. It's just really, really hard to select with no clutch. But, hey.
But, so you said before that you did a lot of hitchhiking. Man, I'm sorry I got your name wrong.
That's okay.
It makes sense because I was thinking of Nigel Gavin.
That's okay. Look, I've forgotten yours already.
It's Jeff.
Jeff, cool.
And LIESBET.
Yeah, I used to do a lot of hitchhiking when I was, like, in university. I'm a musician, so I was like, oh, hold on. Sit up straight, poppers. Yeah, I used to hitchhike home from the city to where I live on the northern beaches, which was about 30 kilometres. And, yeah, you know, sometimes I'd end up walking home, sometimes I'd end up catching a bus, but I'd always try and hitch. Always, usually dressed in a tuxedo, so I usually got a classy.
In a tuxedo?
In a tuxedo, that helps.
Really?
Yeah, that helps in Sydney.
Thank you.
good. That one's fast to find.
This is Darren, the guardian angel.
Oh, I don't know about that. Just gave you a ride.
Yeah, yeah. But dude, it's really cool to meet you, man.
Yeah.
Be safe.
Good to meet you too, and hope you enjoy your stay over here.
We will. Merry Christmas to you.
All right.
I'm just filming you in your truck. Bye.
Go back